Hey everybody, thanks for checking out Ozark Overland Adventures, and we are on another adventure this weekend. But you may notice a few things that are different. Number one, I'm not driving. Kara is. Number two, we're not in my Jeep. We're in Kara's new Jeep, in her Grand Cherokee. And number three, this guy's in the back seat. Nathan, why are you in our back seat?
Let's not talk about it.
Nathan's truck is in the shop and it wasn't ready for this weekend. So, anyway, he drove down and decided to come with us anyway, since we have this nice plush back seat in the Grand Cherokee.
She's Gucci.
And so, Kara's going to be driving, I'm going to be videoing, and Nathan's going to be taking pictures. And we are heading to Oklahoma to run the Green County, Oklahoma Adventure Tour, or the GOAT, as it's known. This is a fairly new route that someone put together. I can't remember his name, but it was designed for adventure motorcyclists. But we're going to go run it. We're meeting our friend Chad and Taylor and Chad's son. And so the four of us are going to be running this weekend.
Who's this Taylor guy?
Yeah, that's a good question. We haven't seen Taylor in years. He was in the Bonfire 2018 video.
Flashback.
And we haven't seen him since then.
So, who?
Yeah, exactly. Anyway, should be fun. We honestly have no idea what we're getting into. We have never run this before. We're not leading this, so it's not.
But first, my French.
Oh, we are making a pit stop in Alma to meet our friend Frankie, who you may remember from OverlandRentals.com, and we are getting a brand new Dometic CFX 355 IM for Kara's Jeep. So she's all excited. And we got the trailer behind us. Anyway, it should be fun. Like I said, we have no idea what we're getting into. There's nothing technical on this route. It's all dirt roads and scenic stuff and that sort of thing. So it'll be a totally different change of pace for us. But anyway, we're not at home. We're not sitting in front of the television, so it's going to be a good weekend. We'll see how it goes.
Well, it's time to go to bed now.
The new chair. Oh, David.
Good morning. Well, we made it into camp about 9 o'clock last night, so it was way too dark to film anything except for some campfire footage. So anyway, we're up. It's just after 7. We're trying to hit the road early because we know we have a lot of miles to cover today. But slept great. We are at Chicken Creek Recreation Area. Is that right?
Yeah. Think so?
Yeah, Chicken Creek.
On Ten Killer.
On Ten Killer Lake in Oklahoma. And I gotta tell you, this place is beautiful.
It's a killer.
She's such a dork. But yeah, this place is beautiful. And the fall colors are amazing. But yeah, we had a great catfish dinner last night in Alma and picked up Kara's new Dometic, which he's super excited about.
Yeah.
What's the temperature, babe?
Let me look on my handy dandy app.
It's right, you're there. There you go.
It is set at 32 degrees, and it's now 34. I've checked it all night.
She's a little too excited about her Bluetooth Dometic connection. Mine's old school and just has Wi-Fi. So, anyway, we are setting up. We're tearing down. There's Chad over there. There's Taylor over there. And anyway, we're getting ready to roll out.
Thank you.
to show you Ember.
Hi.
This is Taylor's little pup.
Hi, everything.
This is Ember.
What is his meal? Oh, hi.
Hey, Ember. This is Taylor's
morning.
Custom overlanding trailer.
It's a little
pop. Oh, with muffins. Isn't this thing cool? What kind of truck bed is this?
Toyota.
A Toyota.
That's cool.
Toyota little pup. This thing is so cool. Number one is accomplished. We stopped at Ten Killer Lake State Park to get Kara a new patch since she's got the patch collection going on. Are you excited?
I am.
So, next stop?
Dollar General.
Oh, the dollar store for Melissa. We're just along for the ride. It's beautiful up here.
Green Country Oklahoma Adventure Tour is an adventure route through the backcountry of northeast Oklahoma. The GOAT, as it's known, follows public roads through a variety of terrain from loose gravel creek beds, mud, steep hills, water crossings, and more. The majority of the route is gravel roads with some connecting highway sections. If that isn't enough, there are several places to go off-road for a little more adventure. The GOAT will take you through many wooded areas, including the Cherokee State Game Refuge, the J.T. Nickel Family Nature and Wildlife Preserve, and the Spavinaw Hills Wildlife Management Area. The route is 438 miles and will probably take several days to complete. The biggest issue we would encounter running the GOAT, or at least the portion that we did, was finding camping spots that we didn't secure in advance. This is not National Forest land, so there are very few free public campgrounds, so be sure and plan your locations ahead of time. There is a Facebook group dedicated to this route that has a ton of helpful information. We'll put the link in the description.
We are about an hour and a half-ish into this trip today, and I gotta say, I am crazy impressed with how beautiful this section of Oklahoma is. My only experience in Oklahoma has been I-40 and the Panhandle and the western section, you know, when we've been heading out to Colorado. And this northeast corner that's still, I guess, still technically part of the Ozark Plateau. It's gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. Now we've, you know, just been on dirt roads and somewhat lame-ish paved roads. But
Chad called it Oklahoma paved roads.
Oh, Oklahoma paved roads.
Because
they're kind of rough. But anyway, so I mean, there's no technical trails, but it's absolutely beautiful through here. Love it. Way different.
suddenly it became a tramp.
I think you're on your frame. Now hit it faster. Chicken. It's almost lunchtime and we've managed to find a couple nice little mildly technical trails, not just dirt roads with a lot of dust. How's the new rig handling, babe?
Really good. We didn't air down though, so it's a little bumpy.
Oh, so far real impressed with the ride quality, even without airing down. So, I'm ready for lunch. I will make you a sandwich.
I definitely don't want any onions on my sandwich.
You want that with the mayonnaise?
Yeah, that's good. Yep.
Say hi. Say hi. Ooh. See what you're cooking.
That's probably enough water for Ranger.
Here we have an electric fence.
Keep going.
Right behind
to keep the wives in.
The wife training facility.
They're waving at us.
The wife training facility with tractors. We don't know what they're training wives to do.
I don't know, this one's already trained.
But Kara's pretty good, so we're gonna keep her. We're not letting her off there.
I know.
So the current theory is that it may be a deer camp and they just think they're being funny.
Yeah.
But who knows?
I'm
gonna Google it when we get home. Wife training facility and see what comes up.
There's a whole bunch of men there and they look like they didn't really know what was going on with their lives. So that's what I would think.
You just insulted everybody that goes to deer camp.
No, just those that decide to claim theirs as wife training facilities.
This is called Bathtub Rocks, and it's located inside the J.T. Nickel Wildlife Preserve. The water has eroded the rocks in such a cool way and dug out some very deep holes in the rocks. Some of them are over 6 feet deep. As you can imagine, this place is very popular in the summertime. All right, well, we are in West Siloam Springs, the place that we were going to camp at that waterfall that I just showed you in the video, was not a very good place. It was super muddy and rutted out and torn up by who knows what. So we are at a gas station in West Siloam Springs and trying to find an alternative. There's a state park not too far from here, but all those campsites were booked. So we're gonna see what happens. Chad thinks he may have found some place on the other side of the river. So we're gonna go check that out. And hopefully we find something. Well, it is just after 7 o'clock and we found a spot to make camp right on the banks of the Illinois River, just south of Siloam Springs, Arkansas. And we've got a fire going, we got chili going, and we're just waiting for dinner time. We are at a private campground. We had to just make do with what we had, but we're here basically by ourselves, and I think it'll be okay. We do have the highway bridge is right over there next to us, but so far not too bad, but we'll make it work. So dinner and chilling around the campfire, that's the plan tonight. Should be pretty good. It's been a really good day. Lots of beautiful spots in Oklahoma that we had no idea existed. Very, very happy about how today went. So, hi, love.
Hi.
Did you have a good day?
It was, except for the one mud hole that I did not want to do.
That was at the campsite that we couldn't camp at. But yeah. But Grand Cherokee performed well otherwise.
It did. And it was super comfy and all the things that you said I can't say compared to your Jeep.
Ranger is exhausted from the day. Aren't you, buddy? Oh. Yeah. Oh, yeah. You tired pup.
We're in Arkansas now. That's what you're doing.
Surprise, surprise.
It's going to be good.
Nathan's cooking chili again.
Shocker. And we appreciate you always.
Well, you're very welcome.
I'm actually really okay with it. Like, this is really good to me.
Yeah.
Matt wanted to camp by water. We have water. All the things are good.
All right, the chili was amazing. But in this Dutch oven is a peach cobbler that Chad very thoughtfully is making because my birthday is Wednesday. And I very much appreciate that. Oh, baby.
It's done.
That looks amazing. I'm sure it's done.
Happy birthday to you.
Yay.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, dear Matt. Happy birthday to you.
We even have ice cream because Chad has a diabetic with a freezer section and he brought ice cream to go with the cobbler. Good morning. It is Sunday morning. We finally get a chance to see what our campsite looked like since we rolled it here in dark, and it's not bad. I'm taking a time lapse of the sunrise. We'll see how that turns out. But there's camp right there. Did get, you know, a decent amount of noise from the bridge, but not too bad. I think we all slept good. We're kind of taking it easy and just chilling this morning. We're not in any big hurry. I think our plan today is to go to Natural Falls State Park, where we actually tried to camp last night, but they're full. Just to see what that's like, and then from there we'll determine if we keep pressing on or if it's late enough to start heading back to home. Nathan's got to be back home at a little after dark. And now that daylight savings time is over, I hate it when daylight savings time ends because no more later nights getting to camp. Anyway, that means he's got to be home about 6-ish. And that's probably a 5-hour drive from here. So we'll have to start heading back to We'll start heading back to our home a little after lunch, or right at lunch. So we'll see how far we get today and see what we do. But it's been a fantastic weekend. Highly recommend this eastern section of Oklahoma. It's beautiful, not technical. So if you're looking for that, this isn't your thing. But if you're just looking for, you know, a great scenic drive and a good way to kind of test the waters, if this overlanding adventure type of thing is something you're interested in, highly recommend it. Good spot to do it. And that was a gunshot. Okay, that's kind of worrisome.
What are you getting out of there?
Ice. We're gonna see how the ice maker or the ice freezer does. It's so cute.
Don't use all of it now.
Well, there's still a whole different
thing. Look at that.
Wink, wink, look.
Aw. That's so cute.
Visit the Dripping Springs Scenic Waterfall. I hope it's more than dripping. What do you think, Ranger? You ready to go see it? All right, this is gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. Well, Natural Falls State Park has been gorgeous. I don't know what else there is to do here. There's a ton of hiking trails that I wish we had time to fully explore down into that little canyon area, but it was very nice and well worth the stop. So if you're ever in this section of Oklahoma and want a beautiful place to hike around, I highly recommend this one. I think this is going to conclude our adventure for the weekend and start making the trek back home. We've got a long drive ahead of us. But it's been an amazing weekend and we have had a blast. This is my friend Chad. I don't think I ever actually introduced you. Don't you like the shirt? He is actually the admin for Oklahoma Overland on Facebook. So,
is that my shirt?
Yeah, Oklahoma Overland. There you go. So if you're interested in any type of Oklahoma off-roading overlanding, he's your guy. He's been our fearless leader on this trip. So, but we have had a blast running a third of the goats.
Quarter.
What, 150 miles out of 480?
Yeah.
Isn't that right? Yeah, so anyway, we've had a blast. It's been great hanging out with Chad again. And this is our first, actually, long-term trip together. So anyway, thanks for watching. Be sure and like and subscribe and, you know, all that good
YouTube stuff. So we appreciate you. And go check out his group on Facebook. Please. Bye.